What? Okay, hi.
Hi, everybody. What's up?
It's a Patreon episode.
Wow, we're Patreonic.
You know what I forgot to... Oh, my God, Andy. Well, first of all, listeners, we have a crazy episode for you today. A couple weeks ago, we promised you an episode where we would... Andy promised he would do a deep dive on nipple variations. And you better believe he fucking delivered. Okay. Yeah. But second, I never told the story of Mouse shitting on the plane.
No, I mean, you kind of recounted it in your stories, but you didn't kind of go over it in a long form way. And I would love to, I mean, this is just another part of her childhood that I've missed due to my job. It's a real cats in the cradle moment.
Yeah. I mean, whew, God, she barely remembers her father. I'll tell you that right now. And it's fine because honestly, she's got daddy issues anyway.
Yeah.
You know, if you're talking about it in the patriarchal sense.
look at her in the background.
She's such a fucking lunatic. She's really upset about OnlyFans banning explicit sexual content. And she's just reacted to that by getting up in front of our windows and showing her nipples to the neighborhood.
Yeah, I saw her snaps about it. And
God.
Yeah.
Full
I'm
pussy.
Super happy about that. Yeah.
Anyway, so she's going through it right now with her dad gone and OnlyFans abandoning her. It's she's really acting out. And I took her on a flight to, where did I go, Andy? Where was I?
San Diego.
I was in San Diego. Correct. Thank you for reminding me. I was in San Diego and I reunited with my best friend Blair, which was so much fun. And we did American Comedy Company and it was just a great fucking weekend. We had such a good time. And Mouse was so good. I mean, she was so good all weekend. Like she did not have a single accident in the hotel room. I was coming back. I was taking her out. We were in a fucking rhythm.
Yeah.
Okay. I was like, this bitch learned to hold it. She is doing it. And then before we got on the, but here's the other thing is like, the whole weekend, she would not touch dog food because I've been feeding her the farmer's dog, which is very bougie. It's like chopped up chicken and vegetables.
It's people food.
It's people food. And she is now very used to that. So when I show her kibble, she's like, did you just shit in my bowl? What is this? What am I supposed to do with this?
Am I supposed to go fuck myself? Is that what this means?
Yeah. Are you trying to tell me to fucking fuck off and die, mom?
Yeah.
And, you know, I try to be like, calm down. I'm just trying to make sure you get something in your stomach. And she's like, how about I fill my stomach with cum? And I'm like, what? Why would you say that?
Disgusting.
And she's like, why would you feed me this? And I'm like, all right. Whatever. So that's not working. So we have to take her out to restaurants and I'm literally ordering food off the menu, putting it on a tiny plate and feeding it to Mouse on the ground all weekend. She's eating like a fucking queen.
Yeah.
Now we're about to get on the plane and she hasn't shit. And I'm like, this is going to be a problem because she farted in the Uber on the way to the airport and I was aghast. Like if I had told the Uber driver it was my dog, he would have looked at the size of my dog and been like, you're lying.
Yeah. It smelled like a zombie queef.
Yeah. I was like, you have IBS. Okay.
Yeah.
And, so I told her, I was like, if you don't shit and you fart on this plane ride, it's going to be a problem for everybody. We get on the plane. Noah, hey, stop dragging your ass on the carpet. And no less than 30 minutes into this plane ride, she farts. And it's bad. It's bad. Okay. I mean, people are looking. People are looking behind them to see what happened, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, holy fuck. Like, everybody thinks that I'm a bitch on the first day of her period, just farting back here, you know? And I'm like, so I like pick her up and put her on my lap, because I know that's not better. It's like bringing the fart closer to everybody else. But I'm also like, and here's the other thing is like every single person on this plane of color is just like this dirty white bitch. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Fuck her and her dirty legs and her dirty dog. I hope she dies.
Like, smells like her wet dog.
Right. And I, so I was like, okay, well, let me just take her out and see if she's okay. You know? So I took her into the bathroom, just like in my arms, and just like put her on the ground with like a, what are those things called? The potty pads. Put her on the ground with the potty pad. Nothing happens. So I was like, okay, let's go back. I put her in the crate. She's there in her carrier under the seat. An hour goes by. We have 2 hours left on the flight at the time this happened. And I smell something and I'm like, that's shit. Like, it was not a fart. You know, a fart crescendos and dies.
It was like that. It was like that final episode of White Lotus where.
Yeah, this was just building and building and building.
There's shit in this room.
Yes. Yeah. And everyone looked at me at the same time, like as if there was turbulence on the flight. Everyone turned to me at the same time. So I just
you were the stewardess and they were like, why is there turbulence?
Yeah, I knew what was going on. I took the entire carrier into the bathroom with me and I opened that thing up and it was like bedlam. Okay. There was diarrhea all over the place. Diarrhea in the mesh, in the like crevice, like in the sheepskin pad that was on the bottom of it, all over Mouse, her paws, her asshole, her fur. She was covered in diarrhea.
It was like a full circle. It was like she'd gone back to when we found her.
Yes, she was exactly. And
he was a little shit covered dog from Bakersfield all over again.
All over again. And she looked up at me like when I opened the crate, she was just like, oh, thank God. Like she came out like a fucking, like I was a search and rescue team and I'd found her under piles of rubble.
She was a Chilean miner.
Yeah. She was gasping for air. And I let her out and she jumps out of the carrier onto the floor and I just get to work. Okay. I found where the baby changing station was. I put that down, started cleaning it out. Stop growling. Okay. I'm sorry that I'm telling the story publicly, but you did it. I start cleaning things up. She's on the floor between my legs. All of a sudden, I feel her little paws on my calves and she was just like, hey, I know you're like super busy right now, but there's more shit. And I look down and there is shit all over my feet, all over the ground. And I'm like,
I didn't know this.
Yeah. There's shit on the floor. Like she's diarrheaed on the floor. And so, and there's a vent, by the way, at the bottom of that door. So I'm like, great. Now it's just all through the plane.
I'm surprised you didn't have to emergency land the plane.
I'm genuinely shocked that I didn't have to emergency land that fucking plane myself. Get over here. Anyway, so I'm just throwing shit out at this point. I'm just taking the inside of the crate and just shoving it in the garbage because that water is just dribbling out. Like I might as well be spitting on my hand trying to clean this diarrhea apocalypse and just like wetting these paper towels and trying to clean the inside and then grabbing Purell wipes and cleaning them with that. Her leash was covered in shit. I mean, everything was covered in shit. Okay. And so then there's no inside to the crate. And then this is where like the dog lover part comes in. Cause I was like, well, I had this like hoodie on that you had given me that was like $75. Like it was like an $80 hoodie. And I was like, well, she has to be comfortable. So I take the hoodie off and I put the hoodie in there and I come out of the bathroom and I'm not wearing the same clothes that I was wearing. So now it just looks like I shit myself and I brought my dog in the bathroom to make myself feel better about it. Like when I tell you, Andy, that no one would look at me for the rest of the, no one would even look at me for the rest of the flight.
Here's the thing too, is and you I'm didn't so happy clean that thing didn't. Off. You didn't clean that thing off well enough that it didn't smell like shit anymore.
I actually think I did, but I also was literally dwelling in the shit. So you know how your nose just gets like, you're just like in it. You're like, I live in shit world now.
Yeah.
I had adapted. I was, this was a part of me now. And I sincerely doubt that anyone outside of that bathroom couldn't smell what was in her crate.
You know, that bathroom was probably kind of close to the Candyman bathroom. That's how bad that bathroom had probably gotten. Like, it sounds like...
If I had called the Candyman, he would have showed up and left. Okay. That's how bad it was.
That was good. That was really good. Oh, man.
He would have been like, this is fucking gross, you gross white bitch. He would have left.